I'm Kirsty Bell, I'm the director of A Bird Flew In. It all happened as I was driving home on the night of lockdown from a film that had to basically wrap early. And I was thinking, oh my God, I've got to go back home, and what's going to happen to the world, basically, not just myself. And then I started to do Zoom meetings like everybody else in the world, and I'd never done them before. And I started to think, I wonder what's going on in their life, etc., etc., and started to doodle and literally drew characters and things and places and everything, and then showed it to a producer friend of mine, and he went, this is a film. I went, don't be so silly, it's just my doodlings, this is what I've been doing. So anyhow, we got a writer on the project, Dominic Wells, and he started work on May the 15th, 2020, and we started to shoot on the 13th of July. And the reason why is it tells the tales of people in certain jobs, that what they did during that period of time when the door shut behind them. It's a bit like capturing any moment in time, isn't it? It's about historical referencing, but also how we felt. So one of the reasons why the film's in black and white isn't to be arty, it's to actually take away the colour, drain the film of all colour, so the emotional impact of lockdown is shown on the screen for all to see. So, I mean, you know, we filmed this before we even knew there was going to be another lockdown. You know, a lot of people have said, why didn't you wait till they all finished? We thought it was finished. So I suppose the way that we completed this film, bearing in mind we completed it under other lockdowns, which is a bit weird that we filmed about lockdown and then we're locked down to finish it. It's almost like there's films within a film within a film there. So hopefully we've captured a state of mind fresh, not in hindsight, actually as it was going on. We're very lucky to know a few people, but also the few people that we know include agents. And bear in mind, these actors hadn't worked. So a lot of people didn't even want to work. They, you know, some people we approached basically said, I'm not ready to come out into the big white. It was a massive thing, you know, going into a set, what was the protocol, what arrangements had we been made to protect them, etc. So the agents were wonderful, you know, going through their books, finding the people who were suitable. And then when people read, for instance, Julie Dray, when she read it, she actually I did a Zoom interview with her. She'd actually dressed exactly how I'd imagined her character, Anna. And then Camilla, she did exactly the same. Jeff Fahey spent hours with me on Zoom going through each of the, you know, aspects of Peter's character, why he was doing it. In fact, he was building on the role a lot. So Derek Jacobi was immense with Francis Barber. Francis happened to be staying with himself, isolating in France. We said to him, we didn't know that. We said, is there somebody in the village that's in a bubble with you guys who could act your maid or a male maid? And he said, well, actually, I've got Francis Barber staying with me. I'm sure she'd be delighted to do the role. So were we fortunate, or did we just hit on a almost like a vein of hope of actors and crew? We inherited a lot of the Batman crew who was stood down. So it was a case of people coming together, wanting to work to make this work, which was a wonderful experience to have, to be honest with you. Very honoured to have had it. I was brought up with my dad, you know, basically educating me about film without me realising he was educating me with black and white film. And I've always been a very, you know, my heart is on my sleeve, I'm very out there with truth, etc. And for me to do a film, it had to be real. You know, for me to actually direct something that was made up or not relevant to my own experiences, I think would have been a leap too far. And, you know, I've had a lot of directors work for me. So I was trying to remember what bits I admired. And also with Ben, my producer, I was thinking, I can't be one of these directors who fly off the handle all the time. I go, if I don't have that crane, my Oscar will be out the window. You know, I had to be very real about our expectations and what we could have. Never mind what we could afford, but literally what we could find or source, or how we could do it because of, you know, the pandemic was still ongoing. So for me, it had to be a story that I could feel in my heart. And because I'd made it up, it was something that I felt honest about when I did it.